also talk a bit about the security situation. Beefed up security, multi-layer security with five companies including paramilitary personnel, NSG commandos, drones and snipers will blanket the national capital. The Rashtrapati Bhavan will feature a three-tier security system. Delhi police personnel will be stationed on the outermost layer with paramilitary forces in the middle and the president's house, the internal security on the innermost layer. Around 2,500 police personnel have been deployed and roads will be shut in central Delhi. Here's a ground report.
करीब करीब 1100 ट्रैफिक पुलिसकर्मी आज अपनी ड्यूटी करेंगे और सब लोग हमारे ट्रैफिक स्टाफ कम्प्लीटली ब्रीफ्ड है. जो भी आज गाड़ियां राष्ट्रपति भवन और उसके आसपास में आएंगी वो करीब 2 बजे से हम उस जोन में रेस्ट्रिक्टेड एंट्री होगी और रेस्ट्रिक्टेड मूवमेंट होगा. ऑलरेडी हम डिटेल्ड ट्रैफिक एडवाइजरी अपलोड कर चुके हैं हमारे सोशल मीडिया हैंडल्स के अंदर. मोटा मोटी मोटे मोटे तौर पर जो भी रोड्स आर लीडिंग टुवर्ड्स राष्ट्रपति भवन उनके पास में जितनी भी रोड्स हैं वहां पर रेस्ट्रिक्टेड मूवमेंट रहेगा आज.
सो यू हर्ड प्रशांत गौतम द डीसीपी सेइंग दैट ऑल द रोड्स दैट लीड टू द राष्ट्रपति भवन विल विटनेस रिस्ट्रिक्टेड मूवमेंट. Mohit continues to be with us on the broadcast. Mohit, of course, this is a grand ceremony. There are going to be foreign dignitaries attending it as well. And amidst all of this, keeping security in mind, and which is the most important aspect, in fact, today, massive preparations underway. People could face some inconvenience, but I believe they've been informed in advance. The travel advisories have come out that in the central Delhi, there are going to be restricted movements, especially on roads that lead to Rashtrapati Bhavan.
Well, yes, in fact, today the central Delhi will complete become a Fort Eswati, and the Times Now viewers are also requested that if they have to take this particular road of the central Delhi, they should avoid it by the evening today post 5 p.m. given the fact that, as you clearly mentioned, that foreign dignitaries, head of state, various VVIP guests, people from all across the field, many of the senior politicians, they will be taking part in the oath-taking ceremony at around 7 p.m. but the route will come place way much before that, because all these head of states also have a massive security cordon, and all their security is the responsibility of the Indian authorities, and hence the roads will be blocked. There will be very restricted movement, and if only you have the pass, your car has the pass of the oath-taking ceremony, then only you will be allowed to go. So clearly by evening the central Delhi will completely become a fortress, and as you can see, as I was showing you around earlier, that how everywhere in central Delhi these posters have put up which say that आधुनिक भारत के निर्माता नरेंद्र मोदी लगातार तीसरी बार प्रधानमंत्री बनेंगे, सभी देशवासियों को बधाई, तीसरी बार मोदी सरकार, सपने नहीं हकीकत चुनते हैं, तभी सब मोदी को.
Right, Mohit, stay on with us. We also have Sabyasachi joining us on the broadcast from the PM's residence from 7 Lok Kalyan Marg. Sabyasachi, the focus will now shift to from where you are reporting, because at around 9 a.m., according to the information that we are getting, the Prime Minister is going to meet those who have been chosen to be part of the cabinet. So whoever makes their way to the Prime Minister's residence, they are going to be very, very carefully monitored. Speculations already have begun. Some confirmations also coming in from the political parties.
Well, absolutely. See, all eyes would be at Prime Minister Narendra Modi's residence today. See, back in 2014 and 2019 as well, we had seen that before Prime Minister Narendra Modi goes to take the oath, the cabinet ministers come at Prime Minister Narendra Modi's residence to have a tea. And this time around, we are hopeful that the same process would be followed. See, some of the names have been certain that they would be finding their place into the Prime Minister Narendra Modi's cabinet, but also there are a lot of suspense surrounding the allies, which ally leader would make it to the Narendra Modi cabinet 3.0. So shortly from now, the ministers would start coming in, the leaders would start coming in at Prime Minister Narendra Modi's residence to meet him. See, yesterday night also a high-level meeting had taken place here at Home Minister Amit Shah's residence surrounding the cabinet. And also a lot of discussion had taken place regarding the cabinet allocation. On one hand, the BJP was having their own set of meeting at JP Nadda's residence, and the allies were having their own postpone meeting at their or at the residence of Nitish Kumar or at the residence of Chirag Paswan. See, all these strategies have been formulated by the allies, and they have all set their agendas and their demands. So all have been met, but right now, shortly from now, the suspense will be over after the leaders start coming in, who will find their place in the cabinet of Prime Minister Narendra Modi, who will, after meeting the leaders, yes, would go at around 6 p.m. is the time when he would take oath for the third time.
Absolutely. Sabyasachi and Mohit, stay on with us. Very